Hey filmmakers, today I'm gonna show you the best tripod that I've ever used. And I've used a lot of tripods over the years, so you're definitely gonna wanna see this one. If you're watching this video right now and you're making videos consistently, but you don't already own a tripod, leave a comment below because I wanna know who you are and how on earth you're getting by. Tripod is like the number one piece of gear in my opinion after the camera and lens. I use it every single day, can't live without it. Now let's take a deep dive into my review of the Benro S8 tripod head paired with the A373F tripod legs. The overall build quality is really nice. The legs are made of aluminum, but you can also get them in carbon fiber if you prefer something lighter. But for me personally, the difference in price really doesn't make up for that little bit of weight. The video head is also made of metal and hard plastic, and it feels really robust and sturdy. Setting up the tripod is really easy to do. The legs have two sections and they both use latches, so you can quickly unclip them on each leg and then just drop them down and latch them back closed. For me, I prefer the latch locks over every other type because you could just clip them open, slide it down and clip it shut, and immediately you're done. Now with the twist lock ones, you don't know, like, have I loosened it enough to pull out the leg? Have I tightened it enough? And sometimes you put it down, it's not tight enough, you gotta tighten it more. Or with the twist lock ones, it's the same problem. You gotta make sure that you've actually tightened it all the way. With the latches, you just close it. If it's closed, it's tight. If it's open, it's loose. And you can visually see that. The tripod plate that it uses is the standard Manfrotto 501 plate. The way that this tripod head is designed, you can only slide the plate in from the back towards the front. You cannot do it the opposite way, going from the front to the back. Now, depending on your rig and setup, this may be a problem for you if you have certain things in the front that can't slide from back to front and they can only go in the other way. A change that I would love to see with this tripod head would be the ability to just clip it in from the top like you're able to do on some other ones instead of actually having to slide it in. When you're using a fluid video head, you need to balance it. Now, you might be asking yourself, why on earth would I balance it? This thing's not a flipping gimbal. Well, you're right, but you want it balanced because it helps give you really smooth tilts. Essentially, when you tilt up or down, you can release the handle and it'll stay in place. That way you get really smooth shots and you're not just sitting there holding it and your hand's kind of jittering and shaking and it's messing with the footage because you're trying to keep the camera held there and keep resistance. You can let go and it'll stay there because it's balanced properly. So running across the top of this video head, there are a bunch of little numbers and ticks. And on the plate itself, there's also a little line drawn on it. What you want to do is slide the camera on and then make sure that all of the knobs are loosened up and there's no resistance turned on. Then you have to let go. And that can be a little bit scary, but you need to see which way the camera leans. You need to counter adjust for that. So if it falls forward, obviously tilt it back a little bit and bring back the weight and vice versa. Once you have the camera in the right spot, it shouldn't fall forward or backwards. It should just stay horizontal right in place. Once you have it there, go ahead and lock it down completely. Once you've done that, you need to start turning up the resistance and see how much resistance you need to keep the camera in place when you're doing tilts. On this fluid head, there's also a counterbalance built in. So it goes anywhere from 0 to 3. And you also want to adjust that knob and get it to the right spot so that it stays in the same spot that you left it and doesn't like spring back up if you turn on too much counterbalance. Now that the tripod head is completely balanced, let's make sure that the whole thing is actually level. So there are two bubble levels on this. There's one on the legs and one on the head. Now the one on the head is the one that I use the most. The beautiful thing about using a ball head tripod is that you could put out the legs at any length that you need to, especially if you're working on uneven ground, and then you can level out the camera's horizon after the fact without adjusting each one of the legs. Because if you've ever had to level a tripod by adjusting each of the individual legs, you know just how frustrating and annoying it is when you're raising one and lowering the other and you're like, it's still not level, what's going on? Well, this one's so easy to do, there's just a little knob underneath, you loosen it up, keep a good firm grip on the tripod head or camera itself to hold that weight, and then just kind of move it around until the little bubble is right in the middle and you know that you're completely level. The awesome thing about this bubble head is that it has a light built in, which makes it so much easier to get your camera level in dark scenarios that we're always working in. The pan bar handle on this is very versatile. It allows you to flip it up or down, or even extend it out really far if you need to be standing back further from your tripod. The cool thing is that you can also move it to the other side, so if you prefer it on the left or right side, or if you want to buy an extra one, you can even put two on there for really steady panning and tilting with two hands. The max weight that this tripod can support is 17.5 pounds. The minimum height is only 12.5 inches, while the max height is 64 inches. The whole tripod weighs 11 pounds. The tripod comes with a really nice padded carrying case with Velcro straps to also keep it in place inside of the case. There's also a zipper inside where the feet and other accessories can be stored. On the back of the bag, there are two backpack straps that pull out and clip together, so you can walk around and get to shoots with this thing on your back so you can have free hands for other gear. The tripod gets very, very low to the ground, only 12.5 inches off of the ground, which is perfect for low shooting, which I do pretty often to get really dramatic shots of characters and put them really big in the scene. If you have that center column like I have on many of my other tripods, the problem is once you get the legs really close to the ground, you have to push it up to get it out of the way, but now your camera's just risen up another foot or two. Now, the advantage of these over ones with spreaders is that you can actually get low. When you're using spreaders, they restrict your ability to get low by so much. The only advantage that I ever see with using a tripod spreader is that when you drop it down, you know your legs are evenly spread out. That's really it. And honestly, I find spreaders to be more of just a complete annoyance than a benefit, so I avoid buying tripods with them on them. Another awesome advantage of this tripod head is that yes, it's a 75 millimeter bull head, but it's also a flat head and it just unscrews right off of the half ball head. Then you could put that flat base onto something like a slider, and I use it on my shark slider all the time and it works perfectly, so it's very versatile. Now let's talk about one other tripod, and that is the Benro Video Hi-Hat. Now this tripod is meant to get really low angle shots, and the name can be confusing because it's called the hi-hat, but it's for low angle shots. The cool thing about it is that it's also a 75 millimeter ball head, so you can just unscrew your S8 tripod head off of your other tripod and then attach it to this one. And it comes with another little knob that's much shorter, so you can get very, very low to the ground. Now, the legs on this are fully adjustable. You can have them in their full upright position, or you can click them to where they're almost laying completely flat on the ground. And then your tripod head is just a few inches off of the ground. The Benro hi-hat allows you to get even closer to the ground than the other tripod, which was only 12.5 inches off the ground. It's super light, it's only 2.8 pounds. The hi-hat also comes with a cute little travel bag that's padded and has Velcro inside to keep it in place. It also has a zipper inside for storing accessories like the spike feet and rubber feet that it comes with, which are really nice options, again, if you're working in grass or a slippery surface. The legs are fully adjustable, so you can use the twist locks to extend them out and get it just right. A huge advantage of using a hi-hat over a normal tripod that gets really low to the ground is that it has such a small footprint. So if you're in a tight space indoors, you can set this thing up and it hardly takes up any floor space. The guys over at Benro were nice enough to send me out these tripods for review, but they didn't pay me to say any of this. Both of these tripods are truly awesome and can make your footage so much smoother and your workflow so much faster and better. I highly recommend them. So if you're interested, definitely check out the links in the description below. And if you want to learn how to light and shoot better videos, hit subscribe right now. I have a ton more videos coming out on shooting, editing, everything like that. All right, I'll see you in the next video.